Hello, today I want to share with you some startup tips for your irrigation system to get it ready for the growing season. Many people will turn their systems off and actually drain them through for the winter months so that there's no freezing in the pipes. If they've been installed properly and cared for properly, if the lines are below the frost line or freeze line in Oklahoma, then some people leave them on and don't worry about them too much. But as you begin to turn on your system for the season, especially if you've had the main water turned off, you want to make sure that as you turn that main water valve on that goes to your main lines to your irrigation system, that you do it slowly and allow the water to slowly fill up those lines. If you turn it on real quick, you'll get what we call water hammer, which will cause a lot of pressure down at the end of the lines, and you'll probably get some bursting or breaking of pipes or fittings, and then you got some real major problems in fixing that you have to do. So make sure that you turn it on slowly. Now, one of the first things you also want to check, maybe even before you probably turn on the main water, is your backflow prevention device. And this is required on all systems, and ours is right here. Actually, we have a large irrigation system out here, so this is a pretty good sized one, but you can see that it's well insulated. So we have a nice insulation blanket on it, and it's been on all winter. So here's our backflow prevention device, and it's been well protected. It looks like one of the filters here has kind of popped out, but that's the first thing you want to check. And if it's been taken apart and uninstalled last fall, then that will be the first thing that you'll put back on, and then slowly turn on that system to make sure there's no leaks. If it's been in place all winter, again, you want to make sure you check it carefully. Make sure that there are no, that that's working properly. You don't have any major leaks. After you turn your main water line on and you're sure that it's all in good order, then you'll just want to do a walkthrough inspection of your landscape. We have in these beds drip irrigation, and in the turf areas we have some pop-up spray heads. And sometimes it's going to be a little bit difficult just to see what the problems are just by walking through, but that's a good place to start. Eventually you'll have to turn the systems on and check it while it's running. But immediately I have found a problem already here on this line. It's been broken. It has a fitting, a T-fitting that's been broken off in the ground. And so we're going to have to clean this up, probably turn it on to flush the dirt out of the pipes and replace this T-fitting. So then we'll walk through and just continue to look for heads. Like I say, we know there's lots of heads in this area here, but they're kind of hidden by the turf. And so we'll have to, we might be able to figure out where they are. I know there's one right here covered up by leaves. But one of the things you'll want to inspect is make sure that they're not heads aren't broken, that they are popping up properly and still straight up and down, vertical, and then as we turn it on, we're going to check to make sure the pattern of the spray is working properly too, so that you're getting all the coverage that you need. So the best way to do that, really, once you get your system turned on, is to go ahead and turn it on manually. So, a screwdriver is very helpful, popping these open, but we'll just pop this valve box open. One of the things you're going to want to look for is you go into your valve boxes, make sure all the wiring's still in good shape, and also make sure there's no nests inside here. Sometimes we get snakes and rats and other things in here. But this is your control valve here, your valve to one line. And this is the main valve that turns it, shuts it on and off. But this little nut right here, or screw on the top, that's how you would turn it on manually. So I would just prop that open, just crack it open a little bit. You can hear the water coming on, and we have our heads popping up over here. So here we have a zone that the heads are popped up. Now I'm going to go ahead and walk around and look at the heads, make sure they're watering properly or positioned properly. And another thing I have is I have some little flags, because once you turn it back off and they pop back down, again, they kind of disappear in the turf. So I can actually mark these heads too, so I know where they are when I turn it back off, if I have to go back and make some adjustments or fix them. This one we can see right off is actually leaning this way. And so the spray is shooting down into the ground. It's not getting the full coverage or shooting from head to head like we want it to. So this one, we're gonna have to come back, dig next to the sprinkler head, and position that so it's shooting straight back up. So we'll come back and check that one here, or fix that one here in a minute. The rest of them look like they're doing pretty good. This one here, it's actually, we have it set to shoot at, or it's supposed to be shooting at a quarter angle, and it's actually about half that. This particular head has an adjustment on it. We can just turn the top of it and open up that spray. So now it's shooting from head to head, and we're getting the coverage that we need. There's also a screw here on the top in the middle, and that helps adjust how far the spray will go. So if it's not shooting as far as it needs to, you may need to open that up to allow more water to come out and go further. Or vice versa, if it's going too far, you can close it off a little bit. But the goal is to get head-to-head adjustments on this, or shoot distances on the spray heads. Now, if you find that some of your heads are plugged up and they're not shooting out properly, you can easily get into them and pull them apart and clean them out. This one was on really tight, and so I needed a pair of pliers, some channel locks to get it open. But be careful as you do this, because this is all plastic, so you don't want to break it. But we got this one loosened up already. So what you can see what it looks like inside. This one has a spring on it, and this is the riser that pops up. And if you twist off the tip, the emitter here, you will see that there's typically going to be a filter in here. And it's a little dirty, but it's not too bad. I can actually see daylight through it. But usually that's the first place you'll look. Make sure that there's not large debris in here, particles of sand or whatnot. You'll flush that out, clean that up real good. And then you'll also want to double check the head itself. You can flush that out, blow on it, try to clean that out, make sure that's all nice and clean, and then just put it all back together again. Be sure to check your controller, make sure that there's power, that it is functioning normally, and that the day and time are correct, and that the stations are set for proper run times this spring. If you don't already have a rain sensor on your system, now would be a good time to install one. Having a rain sensor can keep you from watering when it is not needed, saving a mess and money. And finally, it is a good idea to replace backup batteries in your controllers at this time. Well, these are all the tips we have for you today. We hope that these are helpful in getting your system running and operational efficiently so that you will have good, healthy plants this summer.